This is a late 2013 Mitsubishi Shogun, and in this video I'm just going to go through how you change the coolant. So this is the 3.2 five cylinder diesel, the 4M4 engine. So the first step is to remove your radiator valve. I also then remove the engine cover because you need to get down here, so that just made it a bit easier. And you need to remove this air hose. So you've got a Jubilee type clip there. You've got to remove that hose there and then the other clip from this end of the hose there. That one is a bit awkward.
And then when you've done that, you need to remove this drain screw from the side of the engine. This is 12 millimeters, and that is just down there at the back of the alternator. And it's pretty obvious when you're looking down there because it does protrude quite a bit. So out of there, you're going to get about that much coolant. You could remove this under tray if you wanted to, but it's plastic. I didn't really care about getting that wet. The water will run around the edge and there's not too much on the floor. And then you also need to remove the radiator drain screw, and that's the white plastic screw at the back of the radiator there, just there. And you'll see a lug at the bottom where the water runs out. And out of that one, you'll probably get about twice the amount of coolant. And then the next step is to remove your reservoir bottle. And that is simply held on with this bracket and it slides in there. So there was a 10 millimeter bolt I removed from there because I thought that was holding the bottle down, but it wasn't. This just slides up. So you get your hands underneath it and give it a good yank, but obviously removing the cap and the hoses from the top first, and then empty that. And then that's your cooling system drained. So it's a good idea to give this a good wash while you've got it out, because then it makes it easier to see your levels. Just make sure that slid down in there properly. Your gasket back there, and for now I'm just going to close that up, but we do need to fill that up at the end. So at this stage you could flush the system through, but I don't have any distilled water and I'm not going to put tap water in here, so I'm just going to go ahead and fill it back up now. So for your new coolant you need 12 litres, and what you want is a P-OAT coolant. I'll put all the details in the video description below, but I bought this one from MPM Oils, and it's even got the Mitsubishi Diacrene super long life coolant wording on the front as well, so this meets the original spec. And what I found is this was the cheaper way to buy it. You can buy an unmixed one in 5 litre bottles, but that was about 45 quid. Or you can buy the ready mixed where it's already diluted 50%. Normally that would be more expensive, but in this case at Euro Car Parts it was cheaper to buy it like this in 1 litre bottles. This was even cheaper than buying it in 5 litre bottles. So these ended up costing me today £3.19 each, and you need 12 litres worth. But in the video description below I'll put the link to these and a few other alternatives which are available in the UK. So when it comes to putting the drain plug back, obviously you want to put a new sealing washer on there, and that is an M12x18, and you tighten this up to 31 newton meters, which is easier said than done with the limited access down there. You really need a fine-toothed torque wrench, which I ain't got. And you need to do up the radiator bleed screw. And now you can fill the system back up slowly. I've bought 12 litres of this coolant, but actually the system is 10.5 litre capacity. That's a long wheelbase model with the rear heater. If you've got the short wheelbase Shogun, it's 9 litres you will need. But this stuff was so cheap, I thought I'd buy 12 litres because it just gave me a bit to play with and for future top-ups. it takes a very long time to fill this up because you can't pour it too quickly. So you need to fill this up until it's brimmed to the top as it is. In this case, I've only got 6 litres, well, just over 6 litres of coolant back in, because obviously there's air in the system. So I'm going to attach the hose back up and then run the engine, get it warm so the thermostat opens. I'm also going to fill up the reservoir bottle here to the full mark, run the engine until it's up to temperature, and then let it cool down and top the system back up. And obviously you're going to want to check for leaks at the 2 points you drain the system. It does take a long time to get that temperature gauge up though, but it's starting to move now. So that'll do, I can't get it any hotter than that. So I've measured how much coolant I took out, and it's about 7.5 litres. So after taking the vehicle for a drive, leaving the heater on, and sort of trying to bleed the system, I've used 6, 7. Yeah, I've got 7.5 litres back in, so that's all looking good. So there's about 3 litres of coolant which didn't drain from this system, and I guess this is because it's the long wheelbase 7-seater and it's got that rear heater. But the workshop manual didn't state any additional draining procedure for this. Also, this engine doesn't have a bleed screw. The previous ones had a bleed screw about here. So for bleeding this, what I did is get the engine up to temperature, leave the cap off, let any bubbles escape, not that there really was any. And then overnight, I parked it on a bit of a hill. What I actually did was got the rear wheels off the ramp and lift the ramp a bit up on the front wheels. So it was uphill. Left the radiator cap off, and then any air would then come to the highest point and obviously escape here. This morning I then ran it until it got hot, and a few bubbles did come out. As you can see, it's a bit wet. That's when I was revving it as well. But I did notice some air escape from the system. So anyway, that's all now bled and the job's done. So I hope you found the video useful. If you have, please do click the thumbs up, because that really does help. It helps other people find this channel. And I'll see you on the next one.